Hey guys, it's Mag Synchro with Convertible Turtle Software, or Convertible Turtle Gaming rather, and it's time for Zelda Breakfast of the Wild. And we're going to start this off loading up the game here. Last we left, we just got the Kakariko Village and called it quits for the day. And we're going to pretty much see what we can get into. And whoever's watching right now, I'm going to kind of use you as a brief guinea pig. So I apologize for this. Just testing a few things real quick. Alright. I think that's going to work. Excellent. This is the first village that we come to, the one that the old man told us to get to. And it's pretty much what we'd expect from a feudal, medieval kind of city. We've got festival lights, we've got livestock, we've got all sorts of interesting things. Including this chicken that I'm carrying that's making a ruckus. Throw this in the pen over here. I want to do that because I've been here before and I know that eventually we're going to have to collect all these pen people. Let's go toward the yellow dot. That's always a good thing to go. Button that many times. All right.
So, you're finally awake. It has been quite a long time, Link. I am much older now, but you remember me, don't you?
Thank you.
Huh?
So this kind of becomes a running theme, the whole entire losing the memory thing, guys. Pretty awesome way to give your character not many things to say, though. It's always, I don't know you, I forgot. What do you mean? I've been, you know, asleep for the last 100 years. Really good excuse for story writing development when you're trying to make your protagonist the strong silent type or the near silent type. So when I'm able to let's talk back to her.
Yes.
The greater good. Alright guys, it's popcorn time.
The history of the royal family of Hyrule is also the history of Calamity Ganon, a primal evil that has endured over the ages. This evil has been turned back time and time again by a warrior wielding the soul of a hero and a princess who carries the blood of the goddess. With the passage of time, each conflict with Ganon faded into legend. So listen closely as I tell you of this legend that occurred 10,000 years ago. Hyrule was then blossoming as a highly advanced civilization. Even the most powerful monsters posed little threat to the denizens of the realm. The people thought it wise to utilize their technological prowess to ensure the safety of the land should Calamity Ganon ever return. They constructed 4 mechanical wonders that came to be known as the Divine Beasts. They also built a legion of autonomous weapons called Guardians. The Divine Beasts were piloted by 4 individuals of exceptional skill from across the land. And thus, the plan to neutralize Ganon was forged. Upon Ganon's inevitable return to Hyrule, the princess and the hero fought alongside these 4 champions against this ancient evil. The Guardians were tasked with protecting the hero as the Divine Beasts unleashed a furious attack upon their terrible foe. And when the hero, wielding the sword that seals the darkness, delivered his final blow, the princess used her sacred power to seal away Calamity Ganon. Yeah. Oh.
getting all sorts of quests at this point, guys. So we just went from like one storyline quest to five storyline quests for the main storyline here. So, pretty much... So, 7 in the morning is this hour, apparently. Okay. That's all the stuff there. So... let's see if we can't complete the set here. Just all we needed. I'll take these apples, because apples are good for filling up hit points. And there's a chicken. Let's just grab this chicken, because grabbing those chickens are going to lead us to some good stuff here. Looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, and we already had 4 there before we talked to her. So that's all sorts of great. Cool. Ooh. So here's an armor shop. Awesome. So 700, 600, so 1300, 1800 for a full stealth suit, or 60, 120, so 180, 270 for a full Hylian suit, and we're flat broke. So time to start saying, hey, what would you like to buy for me that's general vendor trash? Alright, so there's some amber, sell all those, 240, hey, we're almost to the 270 we need, so that's good. Some opals, sell all those, so we definitely got the 270, but we need like the 1800 for the other set, so we need basically like, I don't know, we'll call it 2300, just to be good with numbers. All of those, just 120 rupees for all those goblins we killed. Man. The goblin fangs, so all of them, 136 rupees. Sell us a moblin horn. Just for the 5. So the Moblin Fang and the frogs. We're going to go actually make some potions out of those before we sell them off. But before we get going, let's go ahead and get us some new threats.
Ah.
So now we can actually put these on. Looks like that's our old stuff. So Hylian hood, Hylian tunic, and Hylian pants. That's Hylian trousers, Hylian trousers. Wow, we actually already had a pair of those somehow. Okay. That's what I get for not checking my inventory like 8:13 in the morning, so let's she'll buy them for 25. That's I guess my time is worth taking the loss on that, because I've messed up and I really just don't feel like reloading the game to where my save was. But that does mean that I really think I'm going to save my game real quick in case I make another dumb mistake this early in the morning. Alright, so we can buy us a man bun, basically. I mean, I don't know, guys. It's for the stealth bonus. It's not for the man bun. Alright, so we just need to come up with another 1300 and we'll be good for our stealth suit. And that'll allow us to sneak up on stuff a lot easier. Hopefully we can find some people to do some stuff for. Alright. Hey, there's a shroom. Three spirit orbs, so not enough to turn in, because that is a prayer statue over there. Hey, it's a cooking pot. So, we're going to take a frog, and a moblin fang, another frog, and another moblin fang, and we're going to cook these. And the recipe for all the elixirs in this game is one part monster, one part critter. So we got a hasty elixir. So that's something we can sell. And back to our time-honored tradition of all Zelda game of simply breaking open pots. And nothing here. Oh wow, we were a lot closer to that bomb than I thought we were. Wow. Almost blew myself up again, guys. Don't want to make that a common thing for the stream, is blowing myself up. That'd be kind of a really bad way to go about things. Well, we'll talk to them real quick. So she sells carrots, eggs, butter, and guts. Well, the guts is kind of neat to know about. That'll help us with making any kind of elixirs later on. And here is an item shop. As indicated by the universal sign for the item shop, the simple potion. Yeah, we had some other stuff to sell. still a far piece away from the 1300 we need, but we're getting closer, right, guys? Let's sell that hasty elixir.
Ma!
Let's see here. I want to keep the rest of this on us. We've already gotten rid of our extra stuff. Fire arrows, fire arrows.
Ma!
Sure.
Ah!
You got it.
Ma!
So, there's my bow. Got some arrows, but no fire arrows. That's okay. So, back to the things we've said a couple times about this game, guys, is it has a lot of just interesting little factoids about it. So, drawing my arrow, come up to fire, and my arrow's on fire now. So, for this quest, we want to light the torches. We don't have to have fire arrows. We can just come over here to this well-lit fire, light our arrows, and then light the torches. Now, one thing to make mention is wooden weapons, like the bow I'm carrying, can and sometimes will catch on fire, and they will burn all the way to death. So we don't want to be in the fire for too long to get our arrow lit. So there's all the statues. So we're good there. So now we can go back to the crazy lady in the arrow shop. Which is the item shop.
Ah.
Rupees. Hey, we're starting to make our way there. So this is the edge of town. We've been everywhere here, so except for the inn. Now the inns in Zelda are kind of neat. They have two functions. The first function is the time-honored tradition in RPGs of the inn simply taking you and restoring your hit points back to full, charging a nominal fee in some cases. Some games don't require a fee. This one does. The other thing this does is, if you notice the extravagant bed, in this case it's a soft bed. The difference, asking the gal to tell us, that it's got some sort of premium stuff in it. And you'll be more energized than usual.
Ooh.
Well, the more energized than usual boils down to your maximum hearts will be buffed. You'll have, instead of me having 4, I'll wake up with, say, like 5. Or maybe 6. Just depends upon a number of things that I haven't quite got hammered all the way down. But the other thing is if you get some more extravagant bins, like there's a water bed in one of the other areas, or a rock bed with a massage included, you get stamina bonuses as well. No carrots. I'll bring you some carrots. Alright. So we can go buy a carrot, and that's, you know, normally what I would do for this particular quest is just go buy the ingredient, but I think we can do one better. My Cuccos! Oh, they're gone. And I tried to help the guy out, I really did. You guys saw, I mean, He should have 5, but the game just keeps taking away. I'm guessing because I hadn't talked to this guy yet. So, now we'll talk to him. Gotta find his Cuccos for him. So we gotta find some chickens, we gotta find some arrows. We've already talked to this lady. Or not arrows, we gotta find a carrot. Carrots aren't arrows. As if. These are not carrots, these are pumpkins. There's a pumpkin for us now. Hey, yeah, that's cool. He says he'll give you some, but look at this. When you go to try to grab a pumpkin, he wants to charge me 20 rupees for it. So, you know, that's just not happening. Oh, there's a Cucko. Let's go for it. Oh, that's a problem. So I gotta figure out a way to get rid of her. Guys, we might have to kill an NPC. Nah, just kidding. This is a Nintendo game. We're not gonna be killing any NPCs. It's like going into a Disney film expecting the main character to die at the very beginning. Just stay there for now. Find us a chicken. None of the little jars, apparently. Guys, you were here at the very beginning of this outset. We knew that they were chickens. Tired of being manhandled. There's one protected by the crazy lady in the... Oh, there's one. Ah, grab the chicken. Stay, chicken, stay. Hopefully it will. Alright, so we got one out of... He said he had 10, so there's 7 in total what we have to find. So 1 and 7. We're making a little bit of progress. And technically 2, since we can get that lady away. Still gotta find us a carrot before it's dark. Oh, here's another one. Wait a second. So there's a carrot, we just can't pull it. I know. And there's a guy that will give me a free sample. Just like the pumpkin we had. Hey, boy. Alright, see you, man. Appreciate you stopping by and saying hi. there should be chickens on the roof. You know, like the ancient kind of rooster crowing on top of the roof of the building. Oh, here's another chicken. You, sir, come with me. So that's six. You know where the seventh one is. Get over here, apparently, in the next, like, decade, apparently. There we go. Climbing up. Get a better vantage point. To find a chicken. I'm playing one of those old sniper arcade games, scanning the crowd for a target. Rooftop to rooftop. Going out for chickens. Doesn't look like we're gonna find any today, though. For now, we're looking for chickens. The sentry of the plum garden's gone. Huh. Just had to wait for her to go to bed, I guess. To go, guys. Oh, here's one. Just kind of out here in the middle of nowhere, up by the shrine, apparently. Side of the map. We've walked down this trail before already to deliver one of these chickens one time already. Boy. Matter of fact, the one that I'm holding I think is one of the ones I originally put in the bin before we got the quest. So two left. Huck! Well, they're one of our quest givers, so that's great. That's in the pin, though. So hopefully we'll keep it there. Let's see if we can get to the top of this roof. Check us out another vantage point to see if we can find any other chickens. Good mechanic to start up. So it's raining, guys, and as the game's about to tell me, possibly rain makes surfaces slippery. Yep, so this is going to make us trying to go up and down, well, basically traveling the way I like to travel in this game, pretty much going to be difficult to impossible now. Oh, what is this? Snails! That's cool. Don't remember there being snails the first time I played this. At least not here. So that's always awesome. I'm going cuckoo for Cuccos at this point. Oh, wait. What? Oh, an axe. Okay. That is definitely good to know that's there, because axes become semi-important. Can't even climb a tree like a 4-year-old. Rain is just one heck of a mechanic. Well, with the rain, I don't think I'll be able to get up on top of a building at least to get a good vantage point, so let's start going over to the shrine again, because that gives us a pretty good spot to look at. At the very least, we can paraglide places. Oh, there he is. All right, guys, here we go. Paraglide Geronimo! And now we have our last Cucko. So what do we do with it? And our quest log got updated. So once it becomes whatever time of day the guy comes out again, we'll be able to turn it in. So while we're waiting on that one, we got told about some kind of fairy fountain. and I already know where it is from my prior playthrough. So I'm just going to cheat a little in this case. There is an NPC that eventually will walk you up here and show you where the fairy fountain is. The first playthrough, I actually stumbled across it by accident. And then have the NPC show me here, so it's not really jumping the gun too much. I missed it. Well, time to put on the awesome power of the man bun. So these are fairies, and we can catch them, put them in our inventory, and there's a limit to how many we can hold. I believe the game will allow us to have like 7 and the way they work. Hey GTA, how you doing? I almost managed to blow myself up earlier again. You missed it. This time it wasn't with an arrow though, it was actually with a bomb. Not too bad. I've been at this for about 40 minutes so far. Traffic was great, so no problems. Made it to the fairy fountain here, so we're gonna do its little mini quest here. Just needs 100 rupees. Paid to see me try to blow myself up again. Man. Yeah, it was awesome. I was actually trying to save all my weapons. So I managed to put down a bomb near a stack of jars. Blew up the jars. Was great on one side. I thought, hey, I worked on this side of the map. Let's go ahead and try it on this other side of the map. Managed to be too close to it. Blew myself totally off the platform. Did myself some heart's damage. It was great. Take a look. Looks like all that stuff that we sold off to be able to enhance the clothes is what we need to enhance the clothes. Not too hard to come across bokoblin horns, so we can get that easily. And some blue nightshade. Actually, blue nightshade is right around here anyways. So... yeah, it was one of those moments that I realized it was way too early. So I decided to stop messing with my house and come out and do some exploring. Hence the man bun.
Ah!
So we got the clothing enhanced. We're trying to save it for some more stealth stuff, and clearly with the dialogue that we presented there, blue nightshade is the way to go for that, so we're just gonna pick all the blue nightshade we can find right here. I'm guessing Silent Princesses is basically what the tier 2 upgrade would be, because it's kind of all in the same area. But that is the fairy fountain, guys. And all the fairy fountains pretty much do the same thing, except for the horse fairy fountain. But that won't really come into play until we have a horde, which is what we're kind of gathering up the stealth material outfits to do anyways. But for now, let's go ahead and go back to the guy with all his Cuccos. See if he's okay with the number we've presented to him. Which I think he should be okay. It's like 8 o'clock.
Yeah.
Chicken farmer, where are you? Not in the chicken house. I think that's the last. Guess not. Boy, now it's just a pouring storm. So the weather mechanics in this game is actually pretty cool, guys. There's if you'll notice underneath the clock, it kind of gives you the weather report, and everybody reacts to it. Kind of shield themselves, run everywhere. Some of them stand in the rain, just kind of stare. Not sure about those guys. They kind of remind me of turkeys just drowning in the rain. But man, I thought the guy that does the chicken farm quest would be back by now, but maybe he's afraid of getting wet. And of course, with it raining, any kind of fire source, it's not covered. See, the covered lanterns, they're fine. But the open fires that have been out here, like the cooking area, the bonfire, all those get put out. It's just another neat little thing about this rain system that they have. Who's this guy? Oh, that's the same person. It's a girl, not a guy. Okay. Another neat thing is there's actually enemies that are fire as far as an element. Like fire keys, little bats that fly around. Fire choo-choos, little bitty jellies, they're kind of on fire and almost like magma. The rain will actually put those animals out. And once they're put out, a little while later, they'll actually be defeated simply just by the rain, because their element is taken away from them, which is kind of a neat little effect. Well, right now we could really use a fire going.
Yeah!
So we could fast this quest over. Well, that's just one lazy farmer. Not the pumpkin farmer. The pumpkin farmer is pretty cool. But the chicken farmer. had me have to get his chickens for him, and now he can't even be bothered to come out. Hey, here's a carrot, farmer. Let's see if he's got a free sample for us. The response. The guy is like, hey, yeah, yo, that was me. So we got the carrot now that we need for the cooking quest, so that's cool. We could have went and bought one, but we're trying to be frugal. You know, we're hoping to buy this whole entire set of stealth armor, get something a bit more going than just the man bun. Man, this rainstorm just pretty much just got everybody shut in and everything. And, That's a good sign, guys, that we're near the end of the stream when the low battery indicator comes up on the controller. I gotta say, though, this controller I've got's the Nintendo Switch Pro controller, and I have charged it when I first got it, and I've put probably 25, 30 hours into it before having to charge it back. So that's a pretty good... pretty good amount of time on the charge. ₹50, that's good. That's respectable. Alright. Last thing that we have to do, since it's now sunny out, is the cooking quest once this guy gets to the cooking pot. Now, one thing that's really cool about the recipes that you can make is if you go to the item in question, you can go to recipe and it'll tell you what ingredients are required for it. So that's one of the good reasons to do the cooking quest. Now, if it's a simple thing like a baked or a roasted item, no recipe. And if you yourself didn't cook it, no recipe as well. Except for the cooking quest ones. So it's kind of good to know, but... Yeah, GTA, if you're still watching the stream, this right here is basically where the explosion happened. And just kind of the artist's rendition. Put the bomb there, walked about here, and then blew myself a wall like that. Fortunately, it doesn't kill me, but it still kind of stings a little. And I love the fact that when I hit the wall, it basically stoops me over. Alright guys, well with the battery on the controller going low and it getting close to 9 o'clock, and we pretty much, think we've done all the quests over here, guys. Yeah, the kitchen, the coop, and the shrine, That's it. So we're kind of done here for right now. So at this point, guys, I think we're going to call this little area completed. Next week, there won't be any Breakfast at the Wild streams for a bit, because I actually will not be home during breakfast. I'll be working. Instead of working nights, I'll actually be working days for a week, so that's going to be a little weird. So I would be kind of on the lookout for, like, dinner with Link or something along those lines. Not sure what I'm going to call it, or if I'm going to be streaming this or streaming something else. I do know that Monday evening, I'm going to be streaming ARK, Survival Evolved with Easlem of NOM Entertainment. So definitely, you know, check those guys out. And, to be honest, I'm actually not going to be here tomorrow either, so there won't be a stream tomorrow either. So, like, share, comment, subscribe, guys. Next time we play Zelda, we are going to be heading toward one of the other four races. We're here with the Sheikah people, and we're going to go either to the Rito, or the Zora, or the Goron, or the Gerudo. And wherever you'd like me to go, leave it in the comments for this particular video, because we're going to have near a week before we get to play again, possibly at the worst. And that way we'll be able to take it, and whoever, wherever you want to go, we're going to go try to get there and get that Divine Beast taken care of. That'll probably be like a 2 to 3 stream session. But yeah, so thanks for watching, guys. Appreciate it. And take care.